This is the Vernier extra long temperature probe, and the key feature with this is that it has a 30 meter long cord, and this allows you to measure temperatures far away from your collection device. So perhaps you're using a computer indoors and you want to be able to measure the temperature on the roof of the school. You could run that up there if you wanted to. I've used this before to measure the temperature in my attic in the summertime. It was very hot and I placed it at the peak, and so I didn't have to be up there with a standard temperature probe. And the way this works is that there is a thermistor here at the end, and it changes its resistance as a function of temperature. It's actually covered by a little Teflon sheath here that's designed to protect this. You want to be kind of careful that if you ever put this into a stopper or something like that, you don't damage that piece, but that's where the active part of the sensor is. And you can submerge the extra long temperature sensor up until the end of this black wire at the metal tip. And that's one of the common uses of this. If you want to do, a temperature profile of a lake or pond, you can do that, and we're actually going to do that today. So, finish showing you how this works. It's actually two pieces. We've got the wire and the sensor there, and then it plugs into the this part that actually plugs into your data collection device. And so you plug that in, that plugs in here, plug this into your LabQuest in this case, and then you're ready to collect data. Now, before we go out to the pond today, what I would like to do is mark off my temperature probe in different lengths, because what we're going to do is to take this and submerge it into the water, and I'm going to do the temperature profile of the pond. And so I need to know how far down the probe is in the water. And it's not pre-marked, and so one of the things that you can do is you mark it yourself or have your students do it. And I have a tape measure here, and I've got a metric meter, and I've got some tape that I've already cut, and so I just use some bright orange tape here. And what I want to do is to mark this off, and I'm going to mark it in 50 centimeter increments, because I'd like to know, so when I do my collection, I'll drop it by 50 centimeters and keep going down there and look at that temperature profile. So I will mark it off from the end here. I come down to the 50 centimeter mark, and then I'm going to place a piece of tape at that place. I'll center it on the tape, and so I've got that one. And then I will move it down to the meter mark. Place that one. And then I will continue to mark this off in this method. Now, if I were actually doing this in the school with the students, what I probably would do is go ahead and just run the tape out all the way down the hall and run the cord out next to it and have them going and, measuring it that way. That's probably the better way to do it. But once we get this all measured off, we'll be ready to collect data. Now, while we're inside, we'll go ahead and I'll walk you through the process we're going to do to set this up. So again, I need to have that plugged into my this end of the sensor. I need to plug this into an analog port, and so I'll plug it into, say, channel 1, and then we see the default setting for the probe on the LabQuest 2. So I've got it in channel 1, so we have temperature there, degrees C, and the similar defaults that you have on any of our temperature probes and sensors. Time-based graph, 2 samples per second, 180 seconds. Now, since we're going to do the temperature profile of the pond, what I want to do is to change this. I want to change my mode from time-based to events with entry. And events with entry is going to allow me to do this. It allows me to measure one variable with a sensor, and then it allows me to enter in the value that I need to manually enter in. In this case, it's going to be the depth of the sensor into the water. And so I'm going to call this, I'll just call it depth. And done. And the units will be meters. And so I'm okay with that. And so now what's going to happen is that I'm going to lower it down into the water and have it collect data at those different depths. And I'll show you how I'm going to do this here. And I'll do it inside before we go out in the field. So what will happen here is when I hit the collect button, it's going to show me a temperature versus the depth. If I hit the keep button, what will happen is at that instant it makes a measurement, and then it prompts me to manually enter in the value of the depth. So I'll pretend that I'm going to do this. So I'll hit keep. So now it's asking me, you know, what's the depth? So I'm going to say, well, maybe I'm in the air above there. So I just say, I could say zero, or I'm right at the surface. So zero, here we go. Say okay. And now I might say, well, let's say I do put it into the water here, and I'll just hold it in my hand to make the temperature change a little bit. And then I hit keep. And maybe now I say, instead of at zero, now it's at 1 meter, and I say okay. And now I've got my second reading. So I've got a reading here and a reading over there. If I hit stop, then we see the reading here and the reading there for those two different depths in this case. And so what we'll do out in the field is I actually will collect the data looking at different depths, and then we can take a look at our data out in the field. I set up my events with entry mode when I was inside. One of the other things I would like to do is, now that I'm outside and in the sunshine, I would like to change this to the high contrast mode. Make it easier for me to see when I'm out on the lake. And so to do that, I just need to go to my little house and go down to preferences, light and power, high contrast. Check the box next to high contrast. And it will change my contrast, and now I'm good to go out on the lake and collect some data. Now, another thing I did was finished marking my extra long temperature probe inside so that I'm now ready to collect data. So again, these are marked in half meter increments with the orange tape, and it will allow me to lower into the water and measure how deep the sensor is in the water. So I'm now ready to collect some data. So what I will do is start off with just a measurement of the water right at the surface, and I'm going to call that 0 meters. And then I will lower this straight down into the water and record the events with entry mode every time it goes down there. So I am ready to collect, so I press the collect button here. Okay, and the temperature has stabilized. I press keep, and now I can enter in 0 meters. Okay, and now I'm ready for my second measurement. Action. So I've measured down 8 meters, and what I would like to do is continue to measure as I pull the cord back up into the boat. That way I've got double measurements at each depth. So I'll go ahead and record the 8 meter again, and now I can start pulling it up. And now my last point, back to 0 meters. And now I'm ready to come back in. So now that I'm back on land here, we could take a look at our data. And so there's my temperature profile of the pond. And so I've got my scale here, 30 degrees C, 10 degrees C. And we see towards the surface there, it just stays fairly constant. And then it starts to drop off. And then when I get down towards the bottom of the pond there, it levels off again. This might be a perfect time to look at the stats. I might be interested in what was the maximum minimum temperature there. So I'm going to go under Analyze, and I'll go to Statistics, check the box next to Temperature. And then over here we can see that the minimum temperature was 13.7 degrees C at 7.5 meters. The maximum was 27.8 there. On there. It's kind of below that water drop there. One of the things about the LabQuest 2, it's splash resistant, so a little bit of water on the screen won't hurt it, but you don't want to get water in the ports.